Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, everyone. Welcome to episode number 17, Moments with the Qur'an. Today we're going to continue with Surah Yusuf and move on to a more advanced part of the story. Yusuf alayhi salam is the minister. He ran the country during the 7 years of rainfall. He did such a sterling, phenomenal job. Such a good job that he had enough food for Egypt as well as excess food to help surrounding areas afflicted and affected by the famine. And as a result now, his brothers come from Palestine because the famine had affected that area as well. They come into Egypt to get food, and obviously they have no idea that the minister we're going to see is our brother who we left for dead at the bottom of a well decades ago. They have no idea. You know, he was in a well in another land. This is Egypt, right? How on earth is he going to be a minister? It didn't cross their minds. In any case, they meet Yusuf alayhi salam. Yusuf alayhi salam honors them. He knows who they are. They have no idea who he is. And then they ask for a quota of food for one of their brothers who's back home with their father. So Yusuf alayhi salam knows exactly who he is. It's Binyamin, right? His closest brother, meaning in terms of relation, Yusuf alayhi salam and Binyamin, they shared the same mother and father. And he missed his brother. No doubt, right? So Yusuf alayhi salam said the rule is if you present yourself, then you get the quota. You can't say there's a brother back home, give me a quota. And it makes sense, otherwise everyone can say this and the program will be mismanaged. So Yusuf said, bring him and I will hand over the quota. So they went back home, they sat down with Yaqub alayhi salam, their father, and Yaqub alayhi salam was not comfortable at all. And obviously we know he wasn't comfortable because he didn't send Binyamin in the first place during the first travel. So they convinced Yaqub alayhi salam this time to send him. And Yaqub alayhi salam, he learned from what happened in the past with Yusuf. So he put checks and balances in play, even though they're decades, it's decades since Yusuf has left and they're much older. But a father doesn't forget, right? So he puts checks and balances in play to make sure that they come back with Binyamin. And then this caravan with all the brothers departs to Egypt. When they get to Egypt, Yusuf alayhi salam puts into place a plan. And that plan involves a goblet of the palace being put into the sack of Binyamin. And as they were going back to Palestine, a caller calls out as the caravan was leaving that there's a thief amidst this caravan. And now the brothers were relaxed. They said, we've done nothing. But as the bags are open, they find this goblet in the sack of Binyamin. Now remember, Yusuf knows who everybody is. They don't know who Yusuf is. And when this happens and it becomes manifest that subhanallah, Binyamin has the goblet, the brothers speak up and they say, "I yasriq faqad saraqa akhun lahu min qabl." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us this in Surah Yusuf, that this is what they said. "Qala in yasriq faqad saraqa akhun lahu min qabl." Fa'asarraha Yusuf fi nafsihi wa lam yubdiha lahum. قال أنتم شر مكانا والله أعلم بما تصفون. Subhanallah. Yusuf alayhi salam, he listens to them saying about him, right? That if Binyamin stole, then Binyamin had a brother who stole before. This is a blatant lie. How can you say this? But subhanallah, look at Yusuf alayhi salam. Allah says, فَأَسَرَّهَا يُوسُفُ. Yusuf kept calm. He kept everything a secret. He didn't expose himself. He didn't use his authority over them. Subhanallah. He didn't. He was the minister. He could have dealt with them there and then. He could have dealt with them when he first saw them. But now especially, he could have dealt with them, especially since they is basically slandering him, right? Laying false accusation on him in his absence. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Yusuf, within himself, he understood that you people are in a worse situation, and Allah is all aware of what you did and what you say. All right, subhanallah. But the lesson, brothers and sisters in Islam, so many lessons in Surah Yusuf. Wallahi, and Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, when he says that there's over 1,000 lessons in Surah Yusuf, subhanallah, it's not a far statement. The Quran is phenomenally amazing. La ilaha illallah, and we thank Allah for making us from the people of Al Quran. Yusuf alayhi salam, and this is the lesson for today, brothers and sisters in Islam, he did not use his authority at that moment, because it could be said that he would have abused it had he used it, because it was related to a personal matter. And we learn, subhanallah, and in yesterday's lesson we discussed this concept of, when Yusuf said, I want to become in charge of the storage houses, indeed I am trustworthy and knowledgeable. He's trustworthy. Yusuf alayhi salam is not doing what he's doing for himself. He's running this whole program for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's not calling to himself. He's not calling to the support of himself. So he's not going to use this matter. He's not going to use his authority right now in this circumstance to protect himself or defend himself or support himself. He's not calling to himself. He's calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants people to be fed for the sake of Allah. He wants people to be better for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanallah, this shows you amazing patience that Yusuf alayhi salam has and how connected patience is to the quality of being trustworthy. And you can only be a trustworthy person if you have control over yourself. And subhanallah, we see the difference between a person who works to support themselves and a person who works to support the truth. And an example of this can be taken from the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he went to Taif and they stoned him and he bled sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and Allah sent him the angels of the mountains to crush these disbelievers who were hurting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and hurting him and hurting him and hurting him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam never took the option. He said, leave them. They don't know. Perhaps their progeny will understand better. I didn't come to support Muhammad. It's not brand Muhammad that I'm trying to build. It's brand Islam. And if we keep them, they'll have children. And if their children understand, alhamdulillah, Islam grows. And I'm here as a caller to Islam, not a caller to Muhammad. Remember this, brothers and sisters in Islam. This is a very, very important lesson that we take from the life of Yusuf alayhi salam and the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. And also, no doubt, from the life of the best messenger, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If you're doing it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first, not yourself. Do not abuse your authority, do not abuse your power, do not abuse the fact that you have contacts to support yourself, especially when your acts have been for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability and the understanding. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.